Hey guys, my name is Kriyanche and welcome to episode 11 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we started talking about how you're able to automate forestry bees using Logistics Pipes. And in this episode we'll start talking on how to fully automate ore processing using Tinker's Construct smelteries, including automatically refilling it with lava. So let's get started. So, like always, I got myself a cool tutorial world for you set up to pretty much show you the ins and outs of what you need to know to automate this. So, let's quickly run by with what I have. So, like always, the logistics power junction to power this network, a basic pipe connected to that, and the rest is mostly stuff that I kinda discussed in previous episodes, but of course not in this fashion, so I thought it might be cool to actually show you guys. So right here, I got myself 5 Jabba barrels, pretty much to store the processed materials. And connected to them, I got some logistic chassis Mark II pipes, hooked up with both a provider module and a polymorphic item sink module. As you recall, the polymorphic item sink pretty much means that it only accepts items that are currently in it. So in this case, it's specified to only allow lead. And then the provider is not something that you need in this situation, but if you ever want to request items from this barrel using, for example, a logistics requester pipe, you will need a provider module in this thing. Then right here, I got myself a chest, which will pretty much act as the input for ores, obviously with an extractor Mark II module to actually take the items out and put them where they are needed. And then right here is the lava tank with a logistics fluid provider pipe, which I discussed 2 episodes ago, be sure to check that out if you missed it, to pretty much supply lava from one point to your network to another. Then right here are 2 Tinker's Construct smelteries. You might ask, okay, Gorge, why do you have 2 smelteries? That's actually quite a good question, because as you may know, some specific ores form alloys when combined. For example, copper and tin will give you bronze. That is something you definitely want to avoid when processing, for example, copper and tin at the same time. So that's why I have 2 different smelteries. And this is something you really have to keep in mind when setting this up, that when specifying all the ores that are allowed in each smeltery, that they cannot be combined into alloys, unless, of course, that's something you want to have. So keep that in mind. So like I said, I have myself 2 smelteries right here, with a smeltery controller and a smeltery tank. On the smeltery tank, I have myself some logistics fluid supplier pipes connected on either side, which is specified to keep 2,000 millibuckets of lava stored in it, aka 2 buckets, pretty cool. Partial request set to yes, so even if I have less than 2 buckets, it will send it over, pretty cool. Now right here, I got myself an hopper and a chest on top of it. And on the chest, I hooked up a basic logistics pipe. Pretty much why I chose to go with a chest and a hopper instead of a direct connection is in case you overflow with ores. Using a chest, you have a little bit more of a buffer indirectly from the smeltery instead of trying to put it in directly. Pretty cool. Then on the basic logistics pipe, I pretty much configured the ores that I want to allow in the smeltery. So on the smeltery on the left, I configured it to allow lead, gold, and copper ore. And on the right, I configured it to allow iron ore and tin ore. So, you know, they don't form alloys. So again, be sure to check that out. Then on the front of these smelteries, I got myself a smeltery drain, a thermodynamics hardened fluid duct. So it takes the fluid from the smeltery or the molten metal, pours it into a casting table with a ingot mold in it. Underneath that, I got myself a hopper hooked up to a chest to pretty much automatically take the ingots that are poured out here and put them into the chest. And then I got myself a logistics chassis pipe Mark 1 connected to the chest with another extractor Mark 2 module to put it to the only spot in the network that allows it, in this case, of course, the barrels. The reason why I did the chest directly and not hook up the chassis pipe to the casting table is that for some reason it does not work like that. I tested it quite thoroughly and either I'm doing something wrong or it isn't possible to take that out directly unless you're using something like a hopper. So that's why I'm using it in this situation, so that's pretty cool. And of course, like always, you guys probably want to see a little bit of a demonstration, so let's do that. Let's put one of each ore in this system. As you can see, it gets taken out by the chest and sent to the appropriate smeltery. So that is already pretty freaking awesome. Then as you can see, it will take just a moment to actually smelt all the ores up. Of course, as you know, each ore has a different smelting temperature, so one might take a little bit longer than the other, but that's not a big deal, of course, at least not in my opinion. So let's see. Almost done smelting up the gold. Now the gold is done, it will pour it out into the mold. The mold will put it out into the chest, and using the extractor pipe, it will send it to its corresponding location, which is, of course, the barrels. And the cool thing is, you will get 2 ingots per ore that you smelt by default, so this is already quite a good way to both process your ores and double them. So yes, pretty awesome. So like always guys, I definitely hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. And be sure to like, comment and subscribe like always, because that is pretty awesome of you guys. And I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care folks.